Which, by the way, I was in my dressing room before the fight. When he won, I walked out all the way across the arena over to the other side to go talk to him. You know, beating a guy like Volkman the way he did, that was a very impressive fight. He looked very good tonight. And I called him. I said, this kid looks like a one-trick pony, but that one trick he's got is really good. Tonight, going out and beating a guy like Volkman, tonight was a big win for him. And I think not only, you know, the credibility from us, but from the fans and everybody else, even though none of you asked him a question tonight. I respect very much what he did tonight, and he knows that. I went and told him as soon as that fight was over. You know, he's a tough kid that he beat tonight.
So you would agree that it's time for him to step up?
I would agree, yes. Tonight was his coming out party, for sure.
Paul Sass, a day before the UK show, I'm looking at the Underground, and there's a headline that said, I like to be on my back. That's the headline. I like to be on my back. I've never read that shit, ever. You ever read that? I like to be on my back, and that's the headline? I'm like, who is this motherfucker? So I start reading, and what is this about? It totally caught my eye. It said that he's 10-0, and he has like 10 triangles or something, right, this guy?
Yeah.
10-0, 10, I'm like, what the fuck? There's never been a guy like this ever before, right? So, and then, you know, you read the interview, and he's like, I'm not afraid to pull guard, I like to be on my back, I finish everybody off my back. I go, shit, I can't wait to watch this guy fight. So he fights, and sure enough,
me. You show the lights that stole me, turn to a star.
practice.
What do you think of Paul Sass? That guy's awesome.
Yeah. Oh, dude, that's a great. It's funny. We didn't talk about that before. You know, we always got people. You know, before I come out, before we go live, we're in the back watching it, and I had Faber back there, and he's like, "There's no way Sass. It's this kid's a one-trick pony." There's no way he beats Johnson. Johnson's too good of a wrestler. His stand-up's good, and he'll be good at staying out of submissions. And wow, yeah. When that one trick is that good, I guess it's a whole other story.
But I mean, geez.
If you touch the ground with that guy, he's going to get you.
It was
very impressive. And especially doing it against a guy like Michael. Michael is a good fighter and a good, well-rounded fighter. You saw the first one, he got out of that first heel hook, you know, and was in that position, was comfortable. And then he couldn't get out of there. It's like once he got on the ground with him, he couldn't get back to his feet. And that kid kept going for it until he finally got it.